two things are required in order to do adaptive matching. One is target accuracy, and other is number of iterations to be performed. You can define maximum 5 iterations for each adaptive matching in SOLIDWORKS simulations. Note that the target accuracy defines the change in the strain energy in every iteration. By default, the target accuracy is set to 98%. This means that the difference in the strain energy between two consecutive iterations must be less than 2%. Note that SOLIDWORKS simulation stops refining the mesh when the difference in the strain energy between two consecutive iterations is achieved less than 2%. So start our today case study now. First of all, download this C bracket from our video description link. After that, this C bracket is fixed at bottom and a load of 900 Newton is applied at this phase in the Y directions. So start your simulation now. First, you will carry the study without H-type adaptive meshing. New study. Give it a name. Without adaptive. Okay. So assign the material to this C bracket as alloy steel. Sorry, this is the only alloy steel. Now assign the fixtures as well as loads. Fixed geometry option is selected. Select this face. Okay. Now apply the loads. Select the force. Select this face. And force of 900 Newton is applied here. Right click on the mesh. We will create curvature based mesh. From the mesh parameters, select curvature based mesh. Leave other parameters default. So mesh has been created. Now run your study. So our simulation has been completed. You can see that maximum 1 major stresses value is 52 MPa. That is within yield strength of the materials. That is 620 MPa. So our next step is to carry out an adaptive meshing study. So you don't need to create a new study. Just right click on this study, that is a without adaptive, and click on the copy study. Here name it again, that is H adaptive meshing. Okay, so our boundary condition has been copied to H adaptive meshing study. Right click on this H adaptive study type, go to properties. From here, click on adaptive tab, then select the adaptive. Here are the two things, that is the target accuracy, that is has been set to 98%, and set maximum number of loops or iterations to 5. So 98% mean that if the strain energy between If the change in strain energy between two convective attritions is within 2%, then solution will converge or stop. And if it is more than 2%, then solution will continue or go to the next attritions. Okay. So run your study now. Wait until solution completes. This is the loop 3 of 5. Please subscribe our channel for more tutorials. Okay, here is the message that analysis has satisfied the current edge adaptive accuracy of 98.1901%. You may increase the target accuracy to rerun. No. Okay, we don't need to increase the target accuracy more. So you can see the maximum stress value has been changed to 147 MPa for each adaptive meshing. That was, if you click on the width of adaptive meshing, the stress value was 52 MPa, and with adaptive meshing the stress value is 147 MPa. You can also plot convergence history plot. You can see here on the results, right click, define adaptive convergence graph. And here are options. You can select the target accuracy, or you want to check the how stress at each attrition was. You can see the stress values was 50 MPa for first attrition, for initial or start, and for second attrition was 53 MPa. And for third was here 98 MPa, and for last attrition was 147 MPa. So this is the convergence history of the stress. You can also define the target accuracy along with the stress. Here you can see the target accuracy has been achieved. That is less than 1.8%. Okay, and for this the stress is 147 MPa. So this was our today topic, that how we can work with H-type adaptive meshing. And how, if we check click on the mesh, you will see the refinement in the high stress areas. You can see the refinement here, that mesh has been refined in these high stress areas. This one and on this one. If we go to the without adaptive meshing, you will observe that there is no refinement on these areas. So this is the beauty of each type adaptive meshing, that it automatically refines the mesh where high stress concentration occurs. I hope you enjoyed this study. Please make a practice of this simulation tutorials. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye bye.